described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Film Ideas, Inc. presents Dugong and Din. Alone on a vast ocean, a boy paddles a canoe.
A lonely young explorer is heading towards the adventure of a lifetime.
Not far from a tropical beach, a creature with a flat snout rises toward the canoe.
He is about to meet one of the rarest creatures in the ocean.
Wearing goggles, he looks underwater.
The lives of two strangers from two different worlds.
The boy touches it.
Are destined to change forever.
Yellow and black striped fish swim nearby. The boy swims with the creature.
Against all odds, their friendship grows to know no limits.
The boy stands on it with one foot.
Until others arrive who threaten to turn a boy's greatest dream.
An explosion goes off in the water.
Into his worst nightmare.
Viewed from underneath, the boy paddles his canoe and the creature, like a large seal, swims after him.
This is the story of Dugong and Din.
Written in capital letters, title Dugong and Din.
The tiny island of Mantanani nestles in the warm waters of the South China Sea, 20 miles west of North Borneo.
It stretches to a tip at one end and curves at the other end.
This small speck of land is part of the Malaysian state of Sabah.
Small houses and trees with long fronds line a beach.
And is home to just 200 people who rely on one thing for their survival. The sea.
A fishing boat moves across the water.
The day doesn't just start early for the fishermen.
On the beach,
boat builder King Tong is usually the first to rise.
He measures a log.
Dawn is the best time of day to scour the shore to see what the sea has left behind.
Later, with a chisel, he digs out wood to make a canoe.
In the old man's hands, a driftwood log can become something priceless.
Two young men paddle in another canoe. In the village, a woman steps up to some boxes on the sand.
Balnazia is always busy.
She lets out ducks.
As soon as she is awake, she has hungry mouths screaming to be fed. And a 10-year-old son, Din, who leaves everything to the last minute.
Clothes hang in line strung between trees. Balnazia washes more in a tub. The boys put diving goggles in a pack as ducks sip water from a smaller tub. Sitting on the steps to their house, he packs some clothes. She unrolls fabric to dry.
It always makes his mother glad to see him rush happily to school.
He runs off.
But her son is keeping a secret from her and from everyone.
He keeps running away from buildings along the beach.
Each day, he goes to a secluded cove on the other side of the island.
A small windmill turns.
This is his sanctuary, the hiding place where he keeps the most precious thing he owns.
Hanging the pack with his school clothes and shoes on a tree, he takes out the goggles.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.